And finally, from Iraq, Ms. Ameena Hasan. Ms. Hasan, we honor you for your courageous efforts on behalf of the Yezidi religious minority in northern Iraq, for insisting that the world give heed to the horrors that they face, and for your firm commitment to helping the victims and saving lives. We congratulate you and invite you to say a few words about your work and about the situation that now exists in Iraq. Ms. Hasan, thank you.
Shukran. Shukran. Thank you very much, Mr. Secretary of State John Kerry, for this opportunity for me to be here. It's a great honor for me indeed to be here today. Thank you for all these heroes for their extraordinary work and for all those in the attendance. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, I will be talking briefly about what women the minority in Iraq has been subjected to. On August 3rd, 2014, the terrorist ISIS organization, also known as the Islamic State, attacked the province of Sinjar and seized control of the province within hours. And they killed men and women and children. And they also captured more than 5,000 innocent civilians, mostly from among women and children. And they forced women into marriage and sold them on the market, slave market, for many times over, and also subjected women to the worst and most heinous acts of rape and force. Since that day, I totally dedicated myself to help those women who have been captured, and to follow their news and find out their whereabouts. Luckily, I managed with some friends to liberate 100 girls with the support of the government of Kurdistan. Their liberation requires support, especially that they are present in very dangerous areas. Those women managed to be freed, but they continue to live in camps under very difficult psychological and material conditions. One of the survivors talked to me about, told me her story, and now she is a displaced person in a camp in the province of Kurdistan. She told me that every time she left the camp, she felt that people were pointing fingers at her and saying that she was repeatedly raped and was sold repeatedly by the members of this terrorist organization. What happened to those girls cannot be described or understood. They managed to flee Daesh, but they could not survive what happened to them. They have been raped and tortured, and they were also humiliated, and so was their religion. They managed to escape their captures, but they still are in need of psychological and health support, and also to raise public awareness about what happened to them. And that's why I am asking for help in the liberation of more than 3,000 women who are still being captured by the ISIS and are being raped and sold every day. The Yezidis are not the only victims, then, because all people are being exploited all around the world. In the 21st century, there are millions of women, men, and children who are being subjected to illegal trafficking in human beings. My fellow heroes, whom I am very honored to represent you, have dedicated their lives to fight this awful crime, and they work incessantly to fight this serious problem. And they are working to provide shelter and food to the victims, and they also make sure that there is good legal understanding of what trafficking means. We have to have more rigorous laws, and we have to pressure governments so that they can double their efforts, and we have to coordinate coordination with NGOs. Without your efforts, more people would have been in slavery and captivity today. We are all able to make a difference. It is up to us to help our sisters and brothers in their fight for freedom. Thank you for your attention to the issue and the problem of the Yezidis and all those in slavery around the world. We hope together that we would have a human society that can enjoy peace and harmony, and also where everybody came free. Thank you once again for listening to me. Thank you.
For those moving and inspiring words.